Naughty Dog has been responsible for some of the greatest games on the PlayStation platform. From Crash Bandicoot on the original system, to Jak and Daxter on the PlayStation 2, and finally, the acclaimed Uncharted series on the PS3. The Santa Monica-based developer has established itself as one of Sony's premier studios. Now, the company has unveiled its plans for yet another blockbuster franchise, The Last of Us. A post-apocalyptic adventure that promises to bring Naughty Dog's renowned production values and storytelling to an end-of-the-world scenario. At E3 2012, the company blew audiences away with the game's debut trailer featuring extensive gameplay. Let's dig in and see what the tantalizing footage can tell us about The Last of Us. Right off the bat, Naughty Dog impresses by showing off some of the interactive environments in the game. Player-controlled character Joel is shown pushing some furniture up against the door in order to bar the way against his unseen pursuers. Throughout the game, players can manipulate the environment to block doors, establish cover, or get to hard-to-reach places. In the background, we can see Ellie, his 14-year-old fellow survivor and companion for the length of the game. The graphics, from the sweat glistening on Joel's brow to the realistic character animations and stunningly detailed environments, are all rendered in real time on the PlayStation 3 platform. As Joel and Ellie make their way out onto the flooded streets, we get a glimpse of the game's dynamic dialogue system. Ellie casually points out a movie poster plastered on a bus stop, which Joel can interact with using the triangle button in order to spark further conversation with the girl. Players will have the option of delving deep into various conversations to learn more about their partner, or they can remain the strong, silent type if they wish. The duo's father-daughter-like relationship is integral to the player's experience in the game world.
This is fancy. You ever stay at a place like this?
Trudging through the ankle-deep waters of a once-grand hotel lobby, the pair decides to explore the upper stories. While in this demo, they quickly head for the roof. The game world is chock full of useful items for discovery, enemies to fight, and sights to see if players take the time to see it. The Last of Us was designed from the ground up to be a different experience for each gamer's playstyle.
Two of us to put them down.
Wait, how many is that now?
Five just this week.
Should we call around
them? I'm not complaining.
I bet you not. We done here?
Finally, we get our first taste of the game's stealth and action sequences. Joel and Ellie duck behind an air conditioning duct to hide from some dangerous hunters, a band of deadly survivors. In the top left corner, the HUD indicates that Joel is packing a revolver, as well as tells us his health status and current med pack inventory. The game will not feature regenerating health, but will rely on a classic health bar system, possibly to emphasize the constant danger the player is in. Ellie will rely on Joel's med kits to stay alive as well. Various other handguns, rifles, shotguns, bows, and knives will be tucked throughout the game world for the player to find. We can see that he only has 4 bullets out of 6 chambers. In The Last of Us, ammunition is a scarce commodity that should only be used as a last resort. In this demo, the pair decide to sneak through an open window, though another player could have decided to confront their enemies head on. Pouncing from cover, Joel grapples with one of the hostile survivors, finding 2 precious revolver bullets on his person. As he stands over the limp body of his victim, a scavenger spots him, forcing the player into a gunfight. The gunplay appears similar to Naughty Dog's Uncharted series, allowing players to stick to cover and pop up to take pot shots at the bad guys. The game's character animations dynamically change as Joel loses health, causing him to gradually limp and stagger while holding his side from taking too much damage. While Joel's doing the bulk of the work in the fights, Ellie is no helpless bystander. Grabbing a loose brick from the floor, she's ready in case her older comrade gets into trouble, and trouble comes all too quickly as Joel is ambushed by a crazed scavenger with a lead pipe. The melee combat system is also similar to Uncharted's ruthless brawls. Joel emerges successfully from the brief scuffle, holding his gun to the subdued lunatic's temple. Dropping one more of the enemies with his final bullet, Joel then pistol whips his hostage and dies behind an overturned desk as yet another of the hostiles attacks with gun drawn.
Shit!
I know that sound.
Luckily, Ellie came prepared, hurling her brick at the foe's head, a move that dazes him long enough for Joel to close the gap between them and finish the job.
Good job with all the, killing and stuff.
Unfortunately, the noisy confrontation alerted nearby enemies to the pair's presence, so they dive into a nearby room to stay out of sight. Luckily, the demo gives us a nice, long look at the game's inventory interface. On the left, we can see the types of ammo Joel can carry for his various weapons. 9mm rounds, revolver rounds, shotgun shells, rifle rounds, and arrows. To the right side of the screen, there are two categories of items: usable items and raw materials. In order to make something useful, the player can combine two or more scavenged items to make useful supplies. Material is further separated into the categories of battery, binding, alcohol, blade, sugar, explosive, and canister for easy sorting. Here, Joel stuffs some tissue paper into an alcoholic bottle in order to make a fiery Molotov cocktail. Readying his makeshift weapon, the player is shown a helpful throwing arc, likely a feature implemented on all throwing objects in the game. Players can throw grenades, bricks, and other environmental objects and weapons. Joel hits his mark, lighting one of the approaching baddies ablaze, though the other gets away. Brandishing a shotgun, the remaining enemy creeps into the room where Joel and Ellie are hiding. But Joel gets the jump on him, leaping forward and attempting to disarm the bad guy in melee combat. After a short fight, the player is able to subdue him with a swift blow to the head using the butt of the shotgun. But it's not over yet. Joel is assaulted by another hostile, who is able to pin him down and begin strangling our hero on the ground. As his health bar dwindles down even further, Ellie comes to the rescue yet again, leaping onto Joel's would-be murderer and stabbing him through the back. The table's now turned. The survivor begs for mercy, but he won't find it in Joel. From this footage alone, there's no doubt that Naughty Dog has some great gameplay and story concepts on their hands. We'll see if they can deliver on those promises when The Last of Us is released sometime next year. In the meantime, don't stay in the dark. Stay tuned to GamerSpawn for all your trailers, gameplay, and news features on The Last of Us and its development.